If it were me, this is probably what I'd invest in. What do you think of this one?
You join us here in France at the Circuit Paul Ricard for an exciting free practice, hopefully setting the mood for the rest of the weekend.
We're going to be logging some extra data during this session. Nothing you need to worry about, but as we have some new parts, we'll just confirm they're performing to spec.
Thank you.
I know it's tempting to focus entirely on the race, but we should put a bit of time aside to run the qualifying sim program. Try to run it before the end of FP3 if you can. So far, our fastest lap is a 1:42.9.
Program. these results will do.
Though you could definitely do better. Consider giving it another shot. So come on back to the garage. So far, our fastest lap is a 1:42.3. car repairs have set us back a little. We're 20th in the speed trap, 197.2 miles per hour. Okay, let's talk about this track. Late apexes are the name of the game here. We have a bunch of deceptive corners that lead straight into the turning point for the next one. Turns 1 and 2 and pretty much the whole last sector follow this pattern, so think ahead.
Let's try to find a bit more.
program. Final lap of the program. So far, our fastest lap is a 1:38.4. To view current strategy and race objectives, press the MFD button to open the multifunction display, and then press it again to cycle through till you reach the strategy and objective screen. To rerun the program if we can't improve on that time. final lap. This is the final lap of the program. Over, but I'm afraid we didn't get what we needed. Our best lap so far is a 1:38.4. We're 20th in the speed trap, 199.7 miles per hour. We're fifth in the speed trap, 203.5 miles per hour. Final lap of the program.
And with all the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again. Oldtimer, Gasly and Sebastian Vettel. And that's it. Practice is officially over.
Great work out there today. Let's have your thoughts. You spent a lot of time on the track during practice. Does the car have enough reliability to sustain that? You had an incredible pace in practice. Would you say that you're pretty comfortable with the car? You left some body work out there on the track. Were you struggling for grip? Appreciate your time.
there's only one lap of fuel remaining. Rain is forecast in just over 10 minutes time. Rain in 10 minutes. Track is quiet right now. Let's get out on track while it's clear. We could see the rain getting worse in around 5 minutes. Heavy rain on its way. Our best lap so far is a 1:56.9.
Yeah. Obviously, I expected a better session, but these things happen from time to time. Try to make up for it in the race.
Welcome to Le Castellet as we return from across the Atlantic for the 2019 French Grand Prix. Reintroduced to the Formula One calendar just last year after an absence of almost three decades. The circuit Paul Ricard, where racing legends such as Alain Prost gave us some turn one excitement before Valtteri Bottas and Sebastian Vettel and a commanding victory from Lewis Hamilton gave us a brilliant race last year. What, I wonder, will it have in store for us this season? We have 15 corners here at the circuit Paul Ricard, 6 to the left and 9 to the right. The rain is coming down and making for a slippery racing surface, but luckily there is plenty of runoff available, and hopefully we'll be able to avoid bringing out a safety car during today's Grand Prix. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Sebastian Vettel has a clear track ahead of him today. He starts in pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Gasly, Verstappen, Lewis Hamilton, and Grosjean, Hülkenberg, Butler, Weber, and Daniel Ricciardo, Norris, Raikkonen, Alexander Albon, Oldtimer, Russell, Leclerc, Sergio Perez, and Antonio Giovinazzi, Kvyat, and Robert Kubica takes the last spot on the grid. And now, it's time to head down to the track.
This is our engine supplier's home Grand Prix. Let's give them a race worth watching. bad start, but don't overreact. We can salvage this. Race control aren't happy with your creative interpretation of track limits. They've given you a 3-second time penalty.
So after a magnificent race, we can now see the drivers making their way to the podium. Once again, it's the Silver Arrows who take top spot. So, let's review the driver's standings. It's a great result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Charles Leclerc showed exactly how to manage yourself out on the track today. He was almost flawless out there. Incredible stuff.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Mercedes continue to extend their lead.
Well, things didn't really go your way today. Let's have your take. Not the best way to end a race. What went wrong? You had a bit of a rivalry going on, but it looks like he bested you. Do you have any comments about the collisions? Did you feel comfortable in the wet weather today? Appreciate your time.
They aren't coming round to that proposal. Let's try something else. We're asking for too much here. We need to make some compromises. I'm afraid negotiations have broken down, and there's nothing more I can do. Luckily, we had the team's original offer to fall back on. So we've agreed to those terms. We'll have another chance to negotiate down the road.